At least 13 people are dead and 56 others are injured following a Russian missile strike on a shopping mall in central Ukraine. The country's defense ministry says the attack in Kremenchuk was deliberately timed to coincide with the mall's busiest hours and to cause the most casualties. As many as 1,000 people were in the building when the missile struck, igniting a massive fire which took 4 hours to extinguish. The casualty count is still expected to go up. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky calls the attack a brazen terrorist act and says Russia should be relabeled as such.
This morning, I appealed to the United States to recognize Russia as a state that sponsors terrorism. The relevant resolution is approved by a U.S. Senate committee, and a legal decision can be made by the State Department. And such a decision is clearly needed, and it must be supported by the entire democratic world. The Russian state has become the largest terrorist organization in the world, and this is a fact, and this must be a legal fact. And everyone in the world should know that buying or transporting Russian oil, keeping in touch with Russian banks, paying taxes and duties to the Russian state is giving money to terrorists.
Russia, which has captured the eastern city of Severodonetsk after a weeks-long assault, has stepped up missile strikes across Ukraine in recent days.
The attack on a Ukrainian shopping mall earns condemnation from the United Nations and world leaders. G7 leaders who are currently meeting in Germany have called it a war crime. They vow to hold Russian President Vladimir Putin and those responsible for the bombing to account. French President Emmanuel Macron also denouncing the attack as an abomination, while British Prime Minister Boris Johnson says it demonstrates the depths of Putin's cruelty and barbarism. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken says the world is horrified by the latest in Russia's string of atrocities. Ukraine has called for an emergency meeting of the United Nations Security Council over recent Russian strikes on civilian targets. The UN body has scheduled the event for Tuesday.
Filipinos get a preview of the civic and military parades for the Marcos inauguration on Thursday. The rehearsals were held as authorities appealed to anti-Marcos groups to stage their protests online. Raya Kapulong with the details.
Members of BNP and AFP rehearsed for a civic and military parade in front of the National Museum in Manila as part of the preparations for the inauguration of President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Military vehicles and tanks also joined the rehearsal. Policemen were deployed around the museum.
Titingnan natin yung actual na paglalatag natin ng ating security forces dyan, yung mga kagamitan, yung mga kakayanan, nilatag na rin natin. At magkakaroon tayo dyan ng walkthrough. After the walkthrough, magkakaroon sila ng coordinating conference. Then magkakaroon sila ng critics. Titignan, ano ba yung mga i-adjust natin? May kakulangan pa ba?
The Philippine Coast Guard showcased its floating assets that will be deployed at the Manila Bay during the inauguration.
Alam mo, sa ganitong panahon, hindi natin pwedeng ibaliwala, no? Yung mga kung may manggugulo talaga. So tayo, lahat ng angulo, sa lahat ng pwedeng tignan ay tayo ay nagiging alerto. At ang instruction ni Admiral Abu ay maging vigilant sa lahat ng aspeto nitong kadubigan para hindi tayo malusutan kung sakaling may magtatangka talagang manggulo at gumamit ng karagatan at ng Pasig River.
Meanwhile, the progressive group Bayan rejects the suggestion of the PNP to hold online protests instead of physical rallies on the day of the inauguration. Bayan Secretary General Renato Reyes says their protest will push through on June 30. Meanwhile, the Marcos family is on a transition process to become the first family. In a video posted on his YouTube channel, Marcos said they are all adjusting to their new lives as members of the presidential family.
Ang aking may bahay na si Lisa ay nakakalungkot man, naawa nga ako sa kanya, ay kinailangan niyang iwanan muna ang kanyang kasama sa kanyang tinayo na law firm. Si Sando naman, ganun din. Excited na excited din bilang neophyte congressman. Yung dalawa ko pang anak, dahan-dahan nasasanay dahil marami silang bigla na security. Panay nga reklamo.
Raya Kapulong, ABS-CBN News.